today, we will continue our discussion with entrepreneurship. And nandito na tayo sa weeks 3 to 6, recognizing a potential market. So last week, we have covered potential markets, okay? And analyzing the market need. Remember, we have a discussion about markets where we can only see the tip of the icebergs. And it has to be drawn out from needs, wants, basic needs of people. And then from there, you will create your products and services. So, ngayon naman, we will continue that with recognition of a potential market. So, paano ba natin malalaman when there is when the market that is open, no, or market na sa tingin natin, no, where we can sell our products or services is it really has a potential. Kasi of course dilemma yan ng bawat businessman na baka malugi tayo, although inevitable yun, ano, kahit saan business naman. There is always a risk of losing. Parang sugal nga daw yun eh, yung business. But of course, more than the risk, you are also looking at the rewards. So, binabalance mo lang yung perspective of risk and rewards. So, ngayon, titingnan natin yung potential markets, ano, and how we would entail, no, in this business endeavor. So to start off, we also have another quote. This is from Tony Tan Kakchong, ayan, CEO of Jollibee Foods Corporation. So alam naman natin how successful Jollibee is, right? And according to him, if you dream big and put your dreams into action, you will indefinitely make mistakes. But don't be scared to make mistakes. Just be quick to recognize them and learn from them as fast as you can. So, yung mistakes, part yan ng ano eh, any endeavor, no? Kahit hindi business. Kasi talagang we are bound to make mistakes. Ito sabi nga, common cliche na, we are humans. We're only humans, na sabi nga. Born to make mistakes. Okay? So, ganun din sa business, ano? If you would ask successful businessman, kasi nakikita lang natin yung success nila eh, na nakita natin, si Tony Tan, nagawa niya yung Jollibee. Pero hindi mo alam, prior to that, marami din siyang mga failed businesses. Marami din siyang mga endeavors na hindi naging successful. Ganun din sa karamihan ng mga businesses, ano? Ang nakikita lang kasi natin yung silver lining eh, na, uy, ang galing naman niya, ano na, very successful na yung business niya, or ang dami na niyang pera, ang yaman na niya. Ang laki-laki na ng kanyang business. So, yung mistakes, it is a part of risking, ano, to start up a business. So, talagang mangyayari yan. Malulugi ka, may mga customers ka na that will probably take advantage of you, hindi ka babayaran, o di kaya malulugi ka dahil may mga complaints sila, returns, so on and so forth. But don't be scared, sabi niya, no, to make these mistakes. Kasi in reality, we learn from our mistakes. And tayo personally, no, that kung ire-recall natin lahat ng mga moments in our lives na marami tayo, meron tayong mistake. I'm sure yun yung mas naaalala nyo. Kahit kayo, class, no? If you would look back, yung mga times na nagkamali kayo or meron kayong mistake, I'm sure yun yung mas naaalala ninyo eh. No? Kasi, tumatak siya sa isip mo. Or yung moment na yun is very memorable for you. Kasi you learn something from it. Right? So, kahit ako, ganun din eh. Up until now, may mga mistakes ako in the past na yun talaga yung naaalala ko versus a normal day na wala kang ginawang mali, no, or tama yung ginawa mo, mas naaalala talaga natin yung mga mistakes na. But don't be scared, no, kasi talagang normal yan, ano? And just be quick to recognize them and learn from them. Sabi nga nila eh, it's not about making mistakes. It's may concept pa nga tayo tinatawag na failing forward. It's okay to fail, just fail forward or do not repeat them. And minsan, mas may advantage ka pa versus dun sa super conservative na hindi niya alam. Ikaw alam mo na yan eh. Eh siya, hindi pa niya nadadaanan yun. So, you know, several ways on how a business could fail versus dun sa isa na super conservative, hindi pa niya nararanasan yung mga ganyang failures. So, again, just be quick to recognize them, learn from them as fast as you can. So, yun, ano? So, now, when we talk of potential markets, it involves products and services kasi. And ito, medyo napapiyawan na natin ito last meeting. So, may mga products that are tangible, no? Physical, and then there are services, no? Hindi siya physical, wala kang tangible product na mahawakan, but you are availing of a certain service. Okay? So, a product can be defined as anything that we can offer to a market for attention, acquisition, consumption, that could satisfy a need or want. However, the definition of a product does not only involve tangible goods, such as car, fridge, phone, and the definition is extended to include intangible objects as well. Familiar ba kayo class ngayon dun sa tinatawag na NFT or non-fungible token? I'm not sure kung nakakita na kayo ng ganun or na, oh yan, so nakita na ni Marco. Very ano yan ngayon eh, parang popular siya na concept, ano, tsaka marami nagtitrade. Kumari, NBA player, meron siyang NFT. Or sorry, NBA mismo, meron siyang NFT. So, wala kang physical product na mahahawakan. It is intangible, ano? Pero yun yung product, yung digital image, digital card, no? So on and so forth. Okay? So, yan, nandito na tayo sa panahon na maraming produkto that are even intangible, ano? So, we are expanding into the, sabi nga yung metaverse, no? Yung kay Mark Zuckerberg. Na meron kang sarili mong avatar doon and then it's as if you are existing talaga in another space, no? You can buy things, meron kang sariling bahay, it's as if normal ka, pero you are controlling the avatar virtually, no? So you're buying things there. Meron nga, natawa ako na nakaraan kasi gumasto siya ng malaki, ang ginawa niya, bumili siya ng property sa tapat ata nila si Snoop Dogg ba yun, or si Kanye West, no? Imagine, people would spend money for that. Okay? Gagastos sila para sa mga ganong bagay na intangible naman yan. Ano? Wala ka namang nahahawakan dyan. Okay? Pero we've come to a time na ganun talaga eh. If there is a demand for it and people are spending, then who are the businessmen to refuse? Of course, they will be making money from it eh. Diba? Bakit mo tatanggihan? Eh, you will be making money from it. Okay? So, ayun, ano? Products. Therefore, the broad definition of products includes services. So, in reality, no, kaya nga lang, we are just avoiding confusion. Ang services ay nakapailalim din sa produkto. Yun ang katotohanan doon. Ano? But then again, we are just trying to delineate products and services para klaro, no? Kaya we are putting these narrow definitions na ito, this has to be tangible, this one is intangible, so on and so forth. But again, there are exceptions, ano, like yung mga nabanggit ko. And man, kagaya ng sabi dito sa definition, in reality, services are even included in the products. Then, events, person, place, organization, or even ideas. Okay? So ganyan, persons, no? For example, celebrity, ginagastosan niya yung sarili niya, nagpaparitoke, nagpapaganda, nag-gym, so on and so forth. Pag tinanong mo back, why are you doing this? Kasi I consider myself as a product, no? Product ako at ang customer ko ay ang mga tao, no? So, kapag hindi ka na maganda, hindi ka na gwapo, pipili na sila ng ibang gusto nila na parang celebrity, right? So, ganun, ano? So, ganun yung mga concept na yan na yan yung kailangan natin maintindihan, eh. When we talk of business. Okay? So, services are special form of products which consist of activities, benefits or satisfaction offered for sale that are intangible and do not result in the ownership of anything. So a service can thus include banking, airline, travel, communication services, hotel services, and so on. So yan, we're familiar with this, ano? May banking service. We are paying the bank to hold our money, right? To transfer our money. Okay? Pero in reality, ano ba yung produkto na? Wala namang physical, no? Buwar, BDO. Wala namang physical product except for the ATM. Puro services yun, no? Imagine na, napaka-utak ng mga banking services, like for example, BDO. Magta-transfer ka, may bayad ang transfer, no? Ang deposit, meron din silang percentage na kinukuha. Pag nag-inquire ka sa ATM ng balance, may kinukuha din sila, no? So, kumikita sila just by, pero sarili natin pera yun, ano? Pera ng mga tao yan. Pero yung movement, pagtingin, so on and so forth, we are paying them for it, eh, no? So, imagine ganun ka-utak yung mga ganitong mga businesses, ano? So, yan, wala kang physical product, ano? This is just a service. Travel, okay? So, you're going to one place. Yes, there is an airplane. Sa airplane, may mga drinks ka, food, so on and so forth. But what we are paying for is the transport, yung pagpunta mo from one place to another. And minsan, ang binabayaran mo, yung convenience, no? Bakit ka magta-travel ng economy, no? Eh, kasi yun lang ang kaya. Meron naman nagta-travel first class. Ang laki ng diferensya, no? Bakit ka magta-travel ng first class? Eh, you can pay for economy. Eh, kasi gusto ko parang wala akong kasama sa plane. No? Gusto ko ako lang mag-isa doon. Or yung area ko, solo ko lang. Pwede akong humiga, no? I can do anything. Pwede akong mag-order ng drinks. So, on and so on. So, yung mga ganyan, ano? Services yan. Okay? The higher and the more premium the service, the bigger the payment. Hotel, ganun din, ano? Minsan, ang binabayaran mo pa nga yung pangalan, di ba? You're paying for the brand. You're paying for the name. Hotel services. And many others. So, ito mga to, forms of services yan. But then again, nalaman natin kanina na may mga products din na intangible, ano? And it does not always necessarily mean na kapag intangible, service na kagad automatic, no? So, we have to clearly identify it, okay? A product is tangible item that is put on the market for acquisition. So, yan, nabanggit na natin kanina, no? So, when a consumer buys a car, the product comes with a lot of other service responsibilities such as tune-up, maintenance. And then, a laptop buyer now buys a bundle of service benefits in addition to the tangible components of the laptop. So, pag binili mo yung kotse, no, di ba, ang iniisip natin, yes, we have the physical car. Pero marami siyang responsibilities. No? Totoo yan eh. There are a lot of service responsibilities na minsan, pag first-time car buyer ka, hindi mo alam yung mga bagay na yan. Like yan, magpapa-maintenance ka, every 5,000 kilometer na tinakbo, you have a preventive maintenance, no? Yung mga first 5, no? May preventive maintenance ka, and then, habang tumatagal, magkakalayo na yung agwat niya, like every 10,000, no? Magpapa-maintain ka, papatune up. Okay? So, those services, you would have to pay for. Ano pa, insurance, no? Pag syempre pagka nakabangga ka, paano 'yan, 'di ba? Eh kung wala kang malaking pera, 'di ba? Ganun na lang ba 'yon, sira na 'yung sasakyan mo, eh yung sasakyan kasi natin parang 'yun yung kalabaw eh, no? Or yung kabayo, no? 'Yun yung ginagamit natin to travel from one place to another, okay? Kaya very important 'yung sasakyan sa mga nagtatrabaho sa adults, no? So again, ang tinitingnan mo, yung produkto lang, but ang reality niyan, ang binibili ng customer is yung service. Na? So, bakit ang bibilin mo, let's say, Toyota? Eh, kasi Toyota, quality, Plus, yung service nila, mura lang, no? Pagka nagpunta ka sa kasa, so on and so forth. So, yung mga bagay na yun, ano, yun yung tinitingnan ng mga consumers when they buy something. Not just the product, but also the service. So, when you buy a laptop, no, the laptop buyer now buys a bundle of service. So, bakit mo binili yan? Eh, kasi dito nakalagay ito, 1 year warranty, yung isa, 6 months lang. Eh, dito ako sa 1 year kasi mas mahaba to eh. Kung may mangyari dun sa laptop ko, kumari nasira, accidentally na, bigla na lang siya nasira for whatever reason, ano? Then, you can go ahead and choose for this particular service, no? So, yun ang isa sa mga tinitingnan natin. Or what else? Meron pa siya mga may involved na other products na intangible, like, ah, pag binili niyo po ito, ma'am or sir, meron pong kasamang antivirus. Okay? May mga free na software. Yan. Memory. Memory, yes, there is a physical gadget, no? Yung memory pag mag-attach ka. Pero yung memory is intangible yan. No? So, all of these things, ano, are combination of products and services, okay? So, hindi lang yung isang bagay ang binibili natin in reality, but it is a combination of the two. You are buying the product, you are also buying it for the service. Okay? And I hope that's clear with everyone. Can be physical, virtual, durable, such as car, furniture, and computers, and non-durable, such as food and beverages. Virtual products are offerings of services or experience, such as education and so on. Yan. So, services can be consulting with clients, appropriate products for specific purposes, providing advice, yan, working on standard committees, conducting training, educational outreach, so on and so forth. So, yan, nabanggit ko na rin ito in the past, no? Na, yan, for example, you are an engineer, you are a chef, a teacher, yan, a doctor. So here we can see the further differences between products and services, ano? So yan, as we have learned earlier, products can be tangible and both intangible, ano? But just so we are clear and on the same page, the products are tangible, services intangible. Products are more easier to check in terms of quality, no? Kasi may yung quality standards nandun. While for service, it might be subjective, kaya medyo mahirap kasi one service might be good, the other might be bad, and depende yan sa interpretation ng viewer, ano? It may be an asset sometimes, no, yung product. Services involves expenditures without any tangible return of benefit. Products can be physical possession. Services, physical possession is not possible. Can be stored, cannot be stored, can be transported, cannot be transported, so on and so forth. So yan, makikita natin yung further differences between the two, ano po. So next is a couple of things that I would like to show you, like we have here Kodak, we have Nokia, we have BlackBerry, we have Blockbuster, we have Friendster. Some of you might not be familiar with this already, you know. Kodak used to be a film manufacturer, film business, no? They are in charge of making film for cameras. Tapos Nokia was once one of the best leading companies in phone. Wala pang smartphones back then, and also just purely cellular phones. And then BlackBerry, just this year, nag-announce sila that they are closing down, ano? We also have Blockbuster Video. If you're familiar with this, no, para siyang, what do you call this? Video City sa Philippines. And then, we also have Friendster. This is a social media company, no? So, all of these things have now already ceased, no? Ceased existence. So, yung Kodak, wala na, no? Nokia, I'm not sure if it is was this was already acquired by Microsoft, but definitely no longer a big time player in the smartphone market. BlackBerry wala na rin, Blockbuster Video was once offered by Netflix na makipag-partner, they turned it down kasi they believe that the yung VHS, VCDs, no, yung CDs, those are the actual products that customers want. Pero it turned out na hindi, no, kasi nakita natin, no, yung success ng Netflix in their streaming service. And then Friendster, yan, wala na rin yan ngayon, ano, it has been overtaken first by MySpace and then Facebook. So, itong mga to, no, these are just testaments to things concerning product and services that we need innovation, ano. Kailangan talagang innovation, especially if you're running a business. Hindi pwedeng you will rest on your laurels or you will be content with what you already know, no, as a business. Ang needs kasi ng tao, though they might be basic, but they change together with time, no? Nag-iiba-iba yan. And if we lose focus on the actual need, ano ba talaga yung kailangan? Like for example, sa Kodak, ang kailangan ng tao kasi is not necessarily the film, but the memories that the pictures bring. So ang kailangan ng tao, yung photo at yung memory. No po. So, yan, yung pictures, they can already be taken through a smartphone. So, ang bilis na nga kumuha ngayon ng picture eh. Kahit ilang takes pa, no, hindi kagaya dati, you would have to wait for the picture to be developed, no? Tapos, makikita mo doon, nakapikit ka, o di kaya nakanganga, so parang malulungkot ka. Eh, hindi ngayon, pagka-picture mo, uy, ang pangit ko, ulitin mo, isa pa. O take two, take three, tapos may wacky pa, or kung ano-ano. So, yun yung na-miss ng Kodak. Ano, hindi sila nakatingin dun sa talagang kailangan ng tao. Ganon din sa Nokia. Ano, nagpalit-palit sila. Maraming models. Iba-iba yung itsura. Pero, in reality, ang kailangan kasi ng tao, convenience eh. Telecommunication, convenience. So, ngayon, bakit ka pa magdadala ng camera, MP3 player, or iPad, at cellphone na magkakaiwalay when you can have all of those functions in one? At yun na nga yung smartphone, ano? So yun yung na-envision ng creation of smartphones by Apple, by Samsung, and many others. At ngayon, pataasan ng specs ang mga phones eh. Minsan makikita mo yung phone, ganito kataas yung memory, ganito kataas yung CPU, yung processor, so on and so forth, no? So, yan ang pinaglalabanan ngayon ng smartphones market, no? to offer as much convenience as possible to the customers. Okay? Yan yung Netflix din, no? 'Di ba? Ang Netflix nga alam natin for its tagline na Netflix and chill. So, ang kailangan ng tao is to relax, no? Watch, not necessarily the physical VHS or VCD or DVD. At yun yung hindi nakita ng Blockbuster, no? Kaya their failure to innovate, no, made them bankrupt, no? Ganun din ang Friendster. Hindi kagaya kasi ng Facebook, ang daming innovation na ginagawa ng Facebook eh. May marketplace, may gaming, tapos may ngayon yung Messenger talagang na-dominate nila, no? Parang hindi ka na makaalis because you need the Messenger functionality, right? Lahat ng tao nandun, yung mga katrabaho mo, yung mga groups, so on and so forth. Yung pag-call through video, you can also do it through Facebook Messenger. So, yung mga ganong innovation na na-miss neto mga companies na to, no, despite them being big, being large, hindi nila nakita yung mga ganong bagay. Ano? So, another example would be Ministop, no? So Ministop has already closed, no? Kasi it was already acquired by Robinsons Group, and Robinsons Group will assume full ownership of the convenience store chain in the Philippines. So see, kita niya malaking business na yan, established, pero what happened to them, ano? Nalugi din sila. And hindi naman natin sinasabi na kasalanan nila, no, but maybe because of the circumstances ng pandemic, hindi nila kayang sabayan yung ginagawa ng SM Corporation wherein naggagawa sila ng maraming Alpha Mart, ano? In my location alone, I can actually point out 5 Alpha Mart locations na malapit sa aking area. na pwede kong lakarin, no? Yung ganung kabilis na scaling with big capitalization and expansion ang wala ang Ministap, eh, no? So kahit malaking business na siya, pwede pa rin palang ma-dissolve, ano? Kung wala kang enough capital and innovation. Okay? So, these things all boil down to what we call as the concept of marketing myopia, no? So, marketing myopia is a situation when a company has a narrow-minded marketing approach and only focuses mainly on one aspect of many possible marketings. Like, kagaya niyan, yung Kodak, nakafocus sila sa film na ang kailangan naman ng tao ay yung pictures. Yung Nokia, nakafocus sila sa paggawa ng mga bagong phones na ang kailangan ng tao ay convenience, functionality, no? Yun yung minsan namimiss ng mga companies, ano, in making their products and services. Yan, kagaya niyan. Itong example natin, we have a drill. So, minsan gagawa yung drill manufacturer ng iba-ibang kulay, o di kaya lalagyan nila ng iba-iba pang mga burlolo yung drill, kung ano-anong mga attachment, no? So on and so forth. Pero ang reality, ang kailangan ng tao is yung butas. No? Ang kailangan namin is to dig or drill a hole at home. So whoever can offer it fast, efficient, cheap for us, dun kami lilipat, right? So, yung example na yan, ano, kung ang business ay nakafocus sa maling pananaw, ano, iba yung tinitingnan niya. Instead of, you know, focusing on the real need of the consumers, they are in danger of being dissolved. No? Yun yung pwedeng maging problem. Kaya, kailangan, ano, for any business, lawakan natin ang ating perspective. And see to it that the product and services that we will be making will actually focus on a certain market, no? Kasi ito nga, recognizing potential markets. So when you recognize the potential market, you have to understand what do they really need. Ano ba ang kailangan nila? Hindi yung gumawa ka lang ng business, mag-stick ka doon, you fail to innovate, and then one day you will wake up, meron ng bagong player sa field. Okay? So that's it, and I will be giving you an assignment. I'll be posting this in your Google Classroom, so just wait for this, okay?